हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू कॉम्प्यूटोलॉजी एकेडमी एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ एनसीईआरटी फिजिकल ज्योग्राफी क्लास 11th। सो टुडे वी विल सी अबाउट द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ द अर्थ। सो वॉच द वीडियो टिल द एंड, इट विल प्रोवाइड यू वेरियस इंफॉर्मेशन विच आर इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर द प्रीलिम्स एज वेल एज द मेन्स एग्जाम इन द यूपीएससी, एज वेल एज इट विल हेल्प यू इन अदर जनरल कॉम्पिटिशन एंड सिविल सर्विसेज एग्जाम्स। So myself, Vidyanand Singh, let's start. And for other videos which are earlier to this video, you may go to the playlist and watch those videos. So today, we will see the evolution of the Earth. So what is the evolution of the Earth? So as we know all, Earth had formed 4.6 billion years ago. But the Earth was not same in the initial stage, and it has gone through various changes throughout the geographical time scale. Time and again it has evolved, and its geomorphology as well as its atmosphere, its interior, etc., all those things have gone through various changes. So initially the Earth was a barren, rocky, hot object, red hot object. As we know, during the Big Bang theory, the temperature was very high, even unimaginably high, and gradually the temperature came down. So the Earth was initially very hot, rounded object, barren object, which was having the atmosphere of hydrogen and helium. So the Earth was not having the atmosphere of carbon dioxide, nitrogen or oxygen initially, but it was having the atmosphere of hydrogen and helium, which got wiped away due to the solar winds and other factors. So the various physical, chemical and biological processes between 4.6 million billion years ago to till present has made it to evolve the life forms on the surface of the planet. So only we will see how these changes has came through and how does the Earth's surface as well as the life forms evolved on the Earth's surface. So the Earth's interior is having a layered structure, that is different layers till the center it goes. The layers are concentric and at the center there is the core. So we will see in the next slide how it has evolved. So from the outermost end of the atmosphere to the center of the Earth, the material exists are not uniform. As we know, the Earth's atmosphere is in gaseous form, thereafter the crust and mantle and core. So the crust is having the least density while the mantle is having the intermediate density, and thereafter the core is having the highest density. So this is the way the material are arranged on the surface of the Earth as well as the interior of the Earth. The atmospheric matter has least density, as we have discussed earlier, and thereafter till the interior of the Earth the density goes on increasing. Now come to the evolution of the lithosphere. So the Earth was having mostly the volatile state during the primordial stage. So what is the primordial stage? Primordial stage is the stage when the Earth was formed, that is 4.6 billion years ago. At that very time, the Earth was in a volatile state. So because of which it was having very high temperature, and thereafter it was having volatile state. But due to gradual increase in the density, the temperature inside the Earth increased, and due to the attraction towards the center, the density got increased, and because of this increase in density, the temperature inside the Earth's interior goes on increasing. The material inside started to get separated depending on the densities. So according to the density, the different materials melt at different melting points, that is different temperature. So the different materials having different melting points got separated because the material which was having the higher density didn't melted and it sunk towards the center. And what happened, those material which were having the lower melting point, they got melted easily and they floated towards the surface. That is why the surface of the Earth, at the surface of the Earth, the density is about 2.7, while at the center it is about 13.7. So this difference of density is because of the different melting point and different materials having different densities, so they got separated, they got stratified on the interior of the earth and formed the different layers of the earth. So this happened during the cooling of the process, but what happened when the giant impact or the big splat happened, when the moon had formed, as we have seen in the earlier lecture how moon has formed. So during the formation of moon, that is the giant impact or the big splat, what happened, the earth again got heated, and because of this heat there was again the separation of material. As the material got heated, the earth surface as a whole he got heated, so the material that was forming the earth's material, the composition of the earth, those material got again heated, and because of this what happened, again the material got separated and stratified in different layers. So there was a clear cut stratification of the materials inside the earth. So starting from the surface of the earth to the central part, what happens, there is a layered structure. So first the topmost surface is the topmost layer is the crust, thereafter mantle, thereafter outer core and the inner core, as we can see here in the diagram. So now come to the next slide. Now we will see how the atmosphere evolved. So the Earth's atmosphere evolved in various phases. First of all, the Earth's atmosphere was composed of hydrogen and helium. But due to the solar winds, what happened? The Earth's earlier primordial atmosphere got wiped out, and thereafter what happened? The when the Earth was getting cooled, so during the process of cooling of the Earth started to release the gases and the water vapor, and due to this release of gases and water vapor, the Earth got cooled further, and there was more release of gases and water vapor, and this process was called as degassing. So the earlier Earth was formed having the atmosphere of hydrogen and helium, and thereafter the degassing process happened, due to which the gases and the water vapor was released, and what happened, the early atmosphere was largely containing water vapor, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, methane, ammonia and very little of free oxygen. So there was least amount of oxygen which was available at the atmosphere when the next generation atmosphere due to degassing had formed. But what happened, due to various chemical and biological processes, what happened, the Earth's atmosphere had got changed, but it was not changed in the atmosphere itself. What happened, as the Earth continued to get cooled, so because of which what happened, whatever the water vapor got released from the interior of the earth in the atmosphere, that got condensed, and that got condensed and formed the clouds, and thereafter it fell in the form of rainwater. So this rainwater got collected in the earth's surface depressions. So the depressions formed the oceans. So the depressions gave rise to the oceans, and this happened within the 5 million years after the formation of the earth. So if we consider that 4.6 billion years ago that the earth had formed, so the ocean's age may be 4.1 billion years ago. So the oceans are about 4.1 billion years old. So this gave rise to the formation of oceans, and as the oceans formed, so what happened, thereafter the chemical photosynthesis processes started. So sometimes 3.8 million years ago the life began to evolve in the oceans, not on the surface of the earth but in the water that had got collected in the oceans. So here what happened, these life forms started to process, started the process of photosynthesis, but this photosynthesis was not because of the life forms having the green life. So they were using the carbon dioxide, but these were not using the chlorophyll for the photosynthesis. These were cyanobacteria, and this photosynthesis was a type of chemical photosynthesis, and because of this chemical photosynthesis what happened, they started to release the oxygen, and as they started to release the oxygen, so oxygen was getting concentrated into the oceans itself. As the life form was concentrated to the oceans. So what happened? The oxygen that was getting released, that was also concentrated to the oceans itself. And because of which, what happened? The oceans concentration of oxygen in the oceans exceeded its carrying capacity. And because of this, what happened? As the oceans got saturated with oxygen around 2000 million years ago or 2 billion years ago, oxygen began to flood out of the oceans and they started to get into the atmosphere, that is the gaseous layer of the Earth's atmosphere. And the gradually the concentration of oxygen in the atmosphere started to increase. So this was the process of evolution of the atmosphere of the Earth, and this is the geographical time scale of the Earth and the various stages how does the Earth has evolved. So this is 4.6 billion years ago and this is the present time. Okay, and these are the various stages, that is the Hadean time, Archean time, Protozoic time and Phanerozoic time. Okay, these are the eons and these are the eras. Okay, and these are the various periods. So you can go through this and you can learn what has happened at the different time scales and the different periods. These may be asked as in the pre-exam you can find various questions based on these time scales and what has happened at what time. This type of things are asked in the pre-exams as well as it may be asked into the mains exam also. Thank you very much and have a nice day, and do subscribe our channel to get informed whenever we released more videos.